Hello everyone, welcome to System Software and Compilers Module 3 lecture video. In this lecture, the contents covered are LL1 grammars, construction of a predictive parsing table, and non-recursive predicting parsing. LL1 grammars. Predictive parsers, that is recursive descent parsers, those need no backtracking, can be constructed for a class of grammars called LL1. The first L in LL1 stands for scanning the input from left to right, and the second L stands for producing leftmost derivation, and the one for using one input symbol as a look ahead at each step to make a parsing action decisions. The class of LL1 grammars is rich enough to cover most programming constructs, although certain care is needed in writing a suitable grammar for the source language. For example, no left recursive or ambiguous grammar can be LL1. A grammar G is LL1 if and only if whenever A derives alpha or beta are two distinct productions of G, the following conditions hold. First one, for any terminal A, both alpha and beta does not derive the string beginning with A. And second condition is that at most one of these two, alpha and beta, can derive epsilon, but both cannot derive a epsilon. The third condition is that if beta derives a epsilon, then alpha does not derive any string beginning with the terminal symbol that is present in follow of A. In the same way, if alpha derives epsilon, then beta does not derive any string beginning with the terminal symbol present in follow of A. The first two conditions are equivalent to the statement that first of alpha and first of beta are disjoint sets. The third condition, is equivalent to stating that if epsilon is in first of beta, then first of alpha and follow of A are disjoint sets. And likewise, if epsilon is in first of alpha, then first of beta and follow of A are disjoint sets. Predictive parsers can be constructed for LL1 grammars, since the proper productions to apply for a non-terminal can be selected by looking only at the current input symbol. Flow of control constructs with their distinguishing keywords generally satisfy the LL1 constraints. For instance, if we have the productions like statement derives if expression statement else statement or while expression statement or statement list. If we have the productions like this, then the keywords if, while, and the symbol, the opening flower brace, tell us that which alternative is the only one that could possibly succeed if we are to find the statement. Construction of a predictive passing table. Now let us construct the predictive passing table using the algorithm which collects the information from first and follow sets that already we have computed into a passing table M A comma A, which is a two-dimensional array where A is the non-terminal and A is the small a is the terminal symbol and dollar is the input end marker. The algorithm is based on the idea that A derives alpha, the production A derives alpha is chosen if the next input symbol that we are expecting A is in first of alpha. If this A is in first of alpha and we are expecting the terminal symbol A, then we will choose A derives alpha. The only complication that occurs is when alpha is equal to epsilon, or more generally if alpha derives epsilon. In this case we should again choose the production A derives alpha if the current input symbol is in follow of A, or if the dollar is on the input, if the dollar on the input has been reached and the dollar is in follow of A. If after performing the above, there is no production at all in any cell of the table, then the set where we need to set the blank locations of the table to a error entry. Algorithm can be applied to any grammar G to produce a parsing table M. For every LL1 grammar, each parsing table entry uniquely identifies a production or informs about an error. For some grammars, however, the parsing table M may have two or more entries defined. For example, if G is left recursive or ambiguous, then parsing table M will have at least one location with two or more entries of the productions. Although left recursion elimination and factoring are easy to do. There are some grammars for which no amount of alteration will produce an LL1 grammar. Now let us consider the previous expression grammar and use the follow sets and first sets that we have already created to construct the predictive parsing table for the expression grammar. The grammar is E derives T E dash, E dash derives plus T E dash, then T derives F T dash, T dash derives star F T dash or epsilon dash or epsilon, then F derives parenthesized E or ID. So now we write the first set for all the non-terminals. E T E dash T dash F. So we write a first and follow set, first and follow. So first of E dash is first of E is opening parenthesis and ID. Opening parenthesis and ID. T is again opening parenthesis and ID, and E dash is plus epsilon, plus epsilon, and T dash, first of T dash is star and epsilon, star and epsilon, and for F it is opening parenthesis and ID. In the same way for the follow set, for the non-terminal E we have a closing parenthesis and a dollar symbol, and for T we have a plus closing parenthesis and dollar. Then for E dash we have a closing parenthesis and closing parenthesis and dollar. For T dash we have plus closing parenthesis and dollar. For F we have plus star closing parenthesis and dollar. Now we construct the parsing table. The parsing table must be constructed row wise. We need to write the non-terminals, and column wise we need to write the terminal symbols including the dollar symbol. So the parsing table contains E, E dash, E dash, T, T dash, F. So row wise non-terminals written, and now column wise we need to write ID, the terminal symbols, plus then star, then T क्लोजिंग पैरेंथेसिस, ओपनिंग पैरेंथेसिस, क्लोजिंग पैरेंथेसिस एंड डॉलर सिंबल फाइनली. सो नाउ फर्स्ट वी नीड टू कंसीडर द फर्स्ट सेट. सो इफ वी कंसीडर द फर्स्ट सेट ऑफ द नॉन टर्मिनल ई, वी हैव गॉट ओपनिंग पैरेंथेसिस एंड आईडी. टू गेट ओपनिंग पैरेंथेसिस एंड आईडी we have got the production here, E derives TA dash. This is the only one production from E. So we need to use this production to get the open parenthesis or ID symbol as the first symbol. So we have to make an entry of this production in the table for the row non-terminal E and for the terminal ID. So E derives TA dash. The same production must be entered into the row opening parenthesis. So E derives TA dash. Then if we consider the next production, E dash derives plus TA dash. So now we can consider that one. E dash derives plus E. To get a plus, we have to use the production E dash derives plus TA dash. So we need to make an entry as E dash derives plus TA dash. But here when we have got a epsilon, we need to shift for the follow set. So in the follow set for E dash, we have got a closing parenthesis and dollar. Again, we need to make an entry of the production for closing parenthesis and dollar symbol. So to do that one, which production I need to use? So to get a closing parenthesis or the dollar, I need to use the another alternative of E dash production, that is E dash derives epsilon must be used for the closing parenthesis and dollars. So we need to make an entry as E dash derives epsilon and E dash derives epsilon in the dollar column. Then coming to T, so T for the non-terminal T, we have got the first set as opening parenthesis and ID. So we need to consider the production T derives FT dash. So T derives FT dash must be entered in the columns opening parenthesis and ID for the row non-terminal T. So T derives FT dash for the column ID and for the column opening parenthesis. So T derives FT dash. Then coming to T dash, for the non-terminal T dash, we have got the first set as star and epsilon. So here to get a star from T dash, to get a star from T dash, we need to use the production T dash derives star FT dash. So for the star column, we need to make an entry, that is T dash derives star FT dash into the column star for the row T dash. So T dash derives star FT dash. Then in the first set of a T dash, we have got a epsilon. So when we have got a epsilon, we need to make an entry for the symbols present in the follow set. So we have got plus, closing parenthesis and dollar. To get a plus, closing parenthesis, or the dollar, we need to get the alternative of the production T dash, and that production must be entered in these columns plus closing parenthesis and dollar for the row T dash. So here in plus we can write T dash derives epsilon, and in closing parenthesis we can write T dash derives epsilon, and in dollar column also we need to write T dash derives epsilon. Then coming to the last non-terminal F. For the non-terminal F, we have got the opening parenthesis and ID in the first set. So we need to make an entry of the production F derives the parenthesized E in the column opening parenthesis. So F derives parenthesized E must be used to get the opening parenthesis, and to get the ID we have to use the production F derives ID. So in the ID column for the row F we need to make an entry F derives ID. So now we have made the entries for the symbols which are present in the first and follow sets. Now the certain locations are blank here. That is, in the row E we have got a plus star column and closing parenthesis dollar, and for E dash row we have got ID column, star column, opening parenthesis column. Like that for other non-terminal also we have got the blank locations in the table. So these blank notations are entered with the word error. All these blank locations are error entries. So we can write error. Like that we can write for all the locations of the table where there are no productions. So like this we need to construct the passing table. A non-recursive predictive parser can be built by maintaining a stack explicitly rather than implicitly via recursive calls. The parser derives leftmost derivation. If W is the input that has been matched so far, then the stack holds a sequence of grammar symbols alpha such that S derives W alpha, and it is a leftmost derivation in many steps. The table driven parser in the figure has an input buffer, a stack containing a sequence of grammar symbols, a parsing table constructed by the algorithm, and an output stream. The input buffer contains the string to be parsed, followed by the end marker dollar. We reuse the symbol dollar to mark the bottom of the stack, which initially contains the start symbol of the grammar on top of dollar. The parser is controlled by a program that considers X the symbol on top of the stack, and A, the current input symbol. If X is a non-terminal, if X is a non-terminal, the parser chooses an X production by consulting the entry in the passing table M A comma A in the passing table M. Otherwise, it checks for the match between the terminal X symbol and the current input symbol A. The behavior of the parser can be described in terms of its configurations, which give the stack contents and the remaining input. Initially, the parser is in a configuration with the input string W in the input buffer, and the start symbol S of the grammar on top of the stack above the dollar symbol, which is the end marker. The program in the figure uses the predictive parsing table M to produce a predictive parse for the input string W. Consider the expression grammar, and for that expression grammar already we have constructed a parsing table, and the parsing table is shown. On input ID plus ID star ID, the non-recursive predictive parser algorithm makes the sequence of moves, and these moves are shown, and these moves correspond to leftmost derivation. Initially, the grammar symbol which is the start symbol is present on the stack, and the input pointer is pointing to ID. And now on the stack the non-terminal is present, so the parser goes to the passing table and checks the table entry in the location E comma ID, and it gets the production E derives T dash. So the stack symbol E is replaced by T dash, and again the symbol on the stack is now T, which is a non-terminal. Again the parser goes to the passing table and it checks the table entry for T comma ID. So now T derives FT dash is present in the table. So in that location T derives FT dash is present. So the T is replaced by FT dash on the stack. And now the top symbol on the stack is F. Again the parser goes to the passing table and it checks the location F comma ID in the table, so it gets F derives ID. F derives ID, so this F is replaced by ID on the stack. Now the symbol on the stack is ID, and also the input pointer is pointing to ID. Both the symbols gets matched, so the ID from the stack is popped and the input pointer is made to move to the next symbol, and now the input pointer is pointing to plus, and now the top symbol on the stack is T dash. So like that, it the steps are repeated by the parser to match all the symbols present in the input stream, and the parser announces successful parsing of the string when the input is complete and also the stack is empty.